everyone. AMR back in with another episode. So on today's episode, I will be covering the Week 3 Thursday night football game. It is Pittsburgh at Cleveland. This is a divisional showdown. In years past, this has been a very one-sided affair, Pittsburgh just kind of dominating, but we could see a turn of a leaf here. So I want to go ahead and call out some of the key points of the game that you need to pay attention to closely here. We're going to look at the betting lines. We're going to look at the weather report, the injury report, key benefactors of the game, and then as well as averages on the season so far. So as always, if you like today's content, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. Helps me out a ton. But for the game here, you have Cleveland favored by 4 points. I really do think that Cleveland does hit this line or this spread. I think that Cleveland has way more advantages than Pittsburgh at the moment. TJ Watt on the Pittsburgh Steelers, who's not going to be playing due to his pectoral muscle being torn, is a big blow to the Pittsburgh defense. Now, all things being considered, I think Pittsburgh is a very good team and that Cleveland will not have their way with them. But 4 points is really not that hard to cover, especially if you get more than just a field goal. So the over-under is 38. I don't know whether or not it's going to hit this over or under. So this is going to be one of those games where it very well could hit the over. But if you look at the averages on the season, Pittsburgh's only gotten 18.5 points per game and Cleveland's at 28. So I think that a lot of Cleveland's average got kind of skewed a little bit here this last week against the Jets. They did lose that game. They really should have won. But I think that I'm going to go ahead and bet on the under in this contest. I think that Pittsburgh's really going to struggle to get the ball going. Cleveland's defense has been phenomenal so far this year. Let's go ahead and look at those averages or the power rankings, if you will. Pittsburgh on offense ranks 30th, on defense 27th, passing 28th, and rushing 26th, whereas Cleveland is 9th on offense, 1st on defense, 26th on passing, and then 1st on rushing. So as you can tell, having three stats below 10 is really phenomenal for Cleveland. The fact of the matter is that Pittsburgh has all of their stats that are 25 or higher, which is horrible. So I think that the offense of Pittsburgh is just not going to be matched up against the Cleveland Browns that well. That being said, even though Cleveland doesn't have the best, or even though Pittsburgh doesn't have the best defense right now, Cleveland doesn't really have a star quarterback passing the ball. That's why they have 26th there. They really aren't beating teams through the air. They're kind of just hammering down and doubling down on that running game, where you see the Pittsburgh Steelers giving up 83 yards. Oh, I'm sorry. Where you see the Pittsburgh Steelers giving up 128.5 yards per game, but Cleveland is getting 200.5 yards per game rushing. So Cleveland is going to smash the over on what Pittsburgh's been allowing through the running game. The one caveat is that Pittsburgh is giving up 295 yards through the air and Cleveland's only getting 188. I really don't think that Cleveland's going to be trying to pass the ball much. I feel like Cleveland's going to be ahead early and often. So you could really see a quiet game from Jacoby Brissett. Now, let's look at the injury report. So you have Jadeveon Clowney, who is going to be out, and then you have DeMonte Kazee, who is suspended. So Kazee plays for Pittsburgh. He's their safety. He's been suspended. I don't really remember what for, but he's out of the contest. And then Jadeveon Clowney is out. I think that he got injured last week. And so that kind of does take a little bit of a blow to this Cleveland front line, their defense, the defensive line. So take that with a grain of salt, because they have Myles Garrett on the other side, who has been phenomenal, probably the best defensive end in the entire league. So I think that that is going to be enough to contain Najee Harris. So let's go ahead and take a look at some of the rushing statistics so far for both teams. You have Pittsburgh, who's averaging 83 yards a game. Cleveland, who's averaging 200.5. Pittsburgh's allowing 128.5 yards per game. And then Cleveland's giving up 73.5. So the fact of the matter is that Najee's only getting 10 more than what Cleveland's allowing on the season. I don't see this as a barn burner type contest for Najee. I don't think that he gets anywhere near 100 yards. I think he's probably going to finish out with right around like 65. Going to be a quiet day. It's going to be really hard for him to get the ball moving. And I think this is going to be a very cut and dry game. Cleveland, on the other hand, 200 yards rushing and Pittsburgh giving up 128. I think if you got Nick Chubb, you're looking very, very good at this point. he's probably going to get close to 130-ish yards, probably a pair of touchdowns, maybe one, depending if Kareem Hunt comes in and vultures them. But Kareem Hunt's probably going to have another good game, 60 to 70 yards, and probably like 3 to 4 receptions through the air, totaling about 30 yards. So I really do think that Cleveland has their way here. Looking at the weather report, it's going to rain in Cleveland from 4 to 5 p.m., but for game time, it's going to be cloudy. It's going to be a nice night. I don't think that there's going to be anything to worry about from a weather standpoint. Pay attention to it as it gets closer to kickoff. But if there's any type of rain coming or going, then that just doubles down on my thought of the running game being alive in this contest. Now, key matchups. You got Mitch Trubisky, who is going to be, he's going to be underperforming in this contest. He's going to have to throw the ball a lot, and that's what Cleveland wants. Cleveland is very, very good through the air, and I think that Cleveland's defense alone can go ahead and win in this game. So Mitch Trubisky's going to struggle on this one. He's probably going to have 2 or 3 interceptions. I think he's only going to have like sub 200 passing yards. He's not going to have a lot of success, which is going to bring down Deontay Johnson and Pat Freiermuth's safety nets. So don't have too high expectations for this receiving core. I personally think that Deontay Johnson does not score in this contest. I don't even know if Pat Freiermuth scores in this contest. It remains to be seen. Najee Harris is going to struggle. Like, I've already talked about that ad nauseum, so I won't like beat a dead horse here. And then on the Cleveland side, Jacoby Brissett, expect mediocrity. Like, Pittsburgh gives up a lot of passing yards, but that's not Cleveland's game here. You know that Cleveland's going to try and pound the running game, and I really don't feel like he's going to have to step up in the passing game at all. Now, Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt, start them if you got them and have full confidence in them in this game. They are going to excel. They're probably going to win you the week in fantasy. I have a strong sense that the Cleveland running game is going to be one of the best running duos in week 3. And then over at the receiving core, you have Amari Cooper. Amari Cooper showed a lot of promise this past weekend, getting 9 receptions and surpassing the 100-yard mark. I think that it was a very good week for him, but his week 1 performance was pretty bad, so you want to see some more consistency before you can go ahead and start him with a ton of confidence. If you have better options, I would definitely go with better options. Pittsburgh's defense has been just begging people to throw the ball because they get so many interceptions off of it, and Jacoby Brissett's not going to be immune to that. So that's going to do it for this contest here. I think Cleveland wins. I'll go ahead and give my stat line here. I think Cleveland wins 21-10 against the Pittsburgh Steelers. As always, if you like today's content, feel free to like, comment, subscribe. Helps out a ton. I'll catch you in the next one. See you.